Hi, it's Mark from Top Local Lead Generation. We're here with Bernie Pawlik. Pawlik Automotive, 16-time winners of Best Auto Repair in Vancouver. How are you doing today, Bernie?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. So we're going to talk about ABS. What are ABS brakes?
ABS is short for anti-lock brake system. And as the name implies, these brakes are meant to prevent your wheels from locking up. And when wheels lock up, the vehicle can skid and it's a dangerous condition.
So is ABS on all vehicles?
It's on most vehicles. There's a few that aren't, that don't have ABS, but you'll find it on 95% of the cars out on the road.
So what happens when the system fails or doesn't work properly?
Well, what happens when it fails, the vehicle just reverts back to a normal braking system. So your vehicle should stop just fine. You shouldn't really notice a lot of difference. ABS really only works when you're in a panic situation and you have to hit the brakes really hard. Or you're on slippery road conditions. So at that point, if the ABS stopped working, you have to kind of go to what old-fashioned manual controls, which, you know, really work just fine most of the time.
So I guess I jumped a step there. How do ABS brakes work?
Well, basically how they work, there's a computer at the heart of everything, and there's a sensor on each wheel. So the sensors, which are extremely sensitive, like on a millisecond basis, they will actually pick up whether the wheel's accelerating and decelerating and what rate it's doing so. That sends a signal to the computer, so the computer's monitoring the speed of each wheel. And of course, whether you have the brake on or off and how hard you're braking, when it detects that one wheel is slowing down too fast, then at that point it will, it sends a signal to an ABS module. And the ABS module has a number of valves inside, solenoids and valves, and these can adjust the pressure to each wheel, to the brake system of each wheel. So it'll release the pressure to the brake, so thereby stopping that wheel from locking up.
So that sounds pretty complicated. What goes wrong with these ABS systems?
Well, it is complicated. What goes wrong? Wheel speed sensors are probably the most common failure item. They live out in the wheel environment, which is wet, cold, salty. There's a lot of heat. So wheel speed sensors are probably the most common failure item. Next to that, ABS brake modules, which is the central control unit, either the computer or the actual valves will fail as well. But speed sensors are the most common issue.
So what are these expensive repairs?
They can be. Wheel speed sensors really vary in price depending on what vehicle. And sometimes when you replace the ABS sensor, you actually have to replace the whole wheel hub because that's the way the vehicle is manufactured. It's kind of common in a lot of American vehicles where the wheel hub assembly has the ABS sensor and the sensor ring as well. Interestingly enough, with price, we often think of fancy German cars as being the most expensive to repair, but often the ABS wheel speed sensors are extremely cheap for those cars, and they're actually very expensive for Japanese economy cars. So you never know with cars which price is going to be higher or lower than others. But the other thing too that I failed to mention is that diagnosis is needed every time too. So it's important to find the right component. It's a computerized system, so there's a scan tool diagnosis and then individual component testing as well to make sure we replace the right piece.
So what kind of maintenance should I be doing to maintain my ABS system?
Well, there's really nothing you can do to maintain it because most of it is electronic and it'll live and die in its own time. But the one important thing for ABS is to flush the brake fluid regularly, about every 2 to 3 years, depending on where your vehicle is, where you're located. Keeping clean brake fluid and water free is really important because the last thing you want is corrosive brake fluid to start sticking up the ABS valves. And that's really the only thing you can do. Other than that, you just you drive with it and go from there.
So we've been talking with Bernie Pawlik of Pawlik Automotive. They've just won another award as Best Auto Repair in Vancouver. 16 times now. If you are looking for service on your brakes, these are the guys to call. Book your appointment at 604-327-7112. They've got 5 bays open now, or you can check out their website, pawlikautomotive.com. Thanks, Bernie.
Thanks, Mark.